straight on, coming off the immediately, and then the three more at the top.
So how does this look generally? You've got a long story, okay, and it's kind of developed its design as you go along. You've still got a deadline, haven't you?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's
going to take a long time, because we're getting to the autumn.
Yeah.
Well, we've always got to get the lid on pretty quick.
Yeah.
We've got the other post frame arriving next week, and that's actual follow-up very quickly. So by the end of September, given a reasonable catch of weather, we should have a cover over the whole lot. If the weather's not falling, and if that happens, then I think it'll be all right. We get very slippery in the roof, and then they can be fast. But I don't think it will. If you come down here, I'll quickly make sure that they're in there. And keep yourself in the tree.
I will.
I don't
know
how to do it.
Yeah. It's the middle of October. It's been raining every day for a month, and Christmas stonemason is struggling with the wall. My mortar takes days to set, and if the rain hits it, it just washes away.
This was built yesterday, and you know, it's just like when I laid it, just cover it up, because the water gets in behind it, because it's not going off, and you're putting more weight on top of it. And if you're using cement, you know, you build for 3 foot, then build for 3 foot the next day, but this, build for, well, it's just been wet, and it gets really like cobble, but it's not like using these old methods, but it doesn't, you've got to have time, you just can't build one place.
Until the walls are up, the building won't be watertight, but Martin's determined to carry on regardless, and he's driving the small team on. He's still optimistic about the moving in day.
I still think we'll be in. It won't be finished. I never said it'd be finished. But I think we could be inside by the end of September. We want the walls to be built, the plates to be on, partitions to be made, the wires to be done, the plumbing to be done, the carpets to be laid. But I guess it won't happen tomorrow. You know, you're saying finished by Christmas. We all worked on this project job before, and we all look at it and think, well, you've got to be really lucky. But we've got a temporary hiccup.
The south-facing roof structure is supported by acrotrops. Until the walls are built up and can take the weight. Only then can they put the extra weight of the roof tiles on. The pace of building the grime is causing real frustration.
Everybody's getting in each other's way. Really nice. Mm-hmm. You know, in trying to finish it off. And you do get to a point when you think, come on. You know, is it ever going to finish? Very certain building site, to be honest.
It's going to break.
Chris has never known better. Yeah, you kind of 2 weeks, didn't you, Chris? It's been here 6 months. Just going on and on. He can't abandon it now. Unless his finances dictate he does. But, yeah.
It happens for us to get more than 30 years. And I think they're probably quite good at adapting to living in a space that's not a nation brothers. They're able to be surrounded by chaos and chaos. I just can't help that. But I'm sure they can. If you can, then that's fine. You know, he can finish, they can finish it off. You know, the next few years.
I am recording.
It's quite a different life for me as a boy. Everything that's happened has been brilliant. You're completely happy with how it's all going. But if you can't use up our time for you, and possibly our running against it as well. And so we're now sort of a race against time to get in. I think it's frustrating to Martin because he's involved in it. And sometimes he goes out in the morning and he has a vision in his mind of what can be achieved. And he comes back, you know, and goes,
Sergeant,
click on
me when you record.
Stuart Martin's philosophy includes the idea that there's a problem with the building material.
The headphones on.
He's got headphones on.
The top, the timber frame inside, is English oak. The roof, well, the roof is covered in dry wood.
It's the end of November.
And over on the old barn, the thatcher is struggling to keep his reed dry. A job like this would normally take him 6 weeks, but because of the weather, it could take up to 9.
I mean, you're not putting a roofing top on, are you, underneath it?
Oh, no.
Straight onto the rafters. So, is it really that wooden?
It works exactly the same way as you imagine putting a drinking straw, an angle under a dripping tap.
Yeah.
The drip goes down to the end of the straw before it falls off.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely heaving it down. The surface of the tank is just a series of drips, water dripping down, a quarter of an inch in, and it's completely dry.
Shame we don't produce enough meat in Britain. It's such a traditional product, and the thousands of miles it has to travel across Europe to be imported seriously compromises eco credentials. But then finding truly environmentally friendly materials to build your home is a real struggle. Martin knows from experience. After weeks of research, Martin found a form of insulation that's very natural and very local. Dad,
Six
was not
rocket
science.
Put me on your video.
But it's not widely used at the moment, mostly because it's not widely available. A local spinning mill which has equal, more or less, the waste product of their spinning process.
Wool and thatch are natural materials, but Stuart Martin's philosophy also embraces modern eco products. They're installing a heat exchange system which swaps stale air inside their house for pure air from outside their house. On its way in, the cool, fresh air is heated, which means that Stuart Martin constant supply of warm, clean air without ever having to open any windows. They're also taking advantage of the latest in glass technology. The huge south-facing windows are being installed, even though the walls still haven't been completely built around the opening. But as this is the elevation most exposed to the prevailing wind, it's vital to get this last major element of weatherproofing in place. The glass units are double glazed and filled with argon, making them thermally efficient as standard double glazing. So how is your budget going up for these investments?
Groaning.
I mean,
probably...
We haven't ever seen it, but we are
reaching
it.
It's several months ago,
relocating the recycling, C&C, what could you do? Jordan Ramsey investigates why up to 70 million sharks are killed for their fins every year.
This is all for shark fins,
confronting those responsible for this brutal global trade.
It's got a dog.
Let's get out of it.
Gordon Ramsay, shark bait, as part of a big fish fight, Sunday at 9 on the 4.
Hello. With the BBC.
plus cock. You can record one show while watching another. So you can be here, while your cock's recording here. Here. Box recording here. 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 Bye today. Watch today. Free forever.
What if you could find someone amazing? What if you could be loved for exactly who you are? Now to chat with In Harmony. We'll match you with someone you'll be deeply compatible with. And it all starts with your personality profile. Get yours free today at inharmony.co.uk.
Are you still paying full price for your ticket at the station on the day? People buying in advance at thetrainline.com saved an average of 43%.
Good night.